first started, it was all based around you and your laptop, and now it's kind of formed a bit more than that. Do you kind of miss your original roots there? Like,
it's fun, you know, just being on stage just with the computer, because it's more like theater. But with a live drummer, I think the perfect balance is a live drummer and me plus another MC, or just me and the drummer and the track and video. Because it's simple. Like, I don't need too many guitars. Like, if I'm doing a hip-hop set, it's fun to make it simple. Because hip-hop is really just about the beat, you know, the drum.
You tried a band form, a whole band format before. Did that quite not work out for you, what you wanted?
Well, you know, Failsafe are the best at, like, they backed me up on a bunch of tours at Give It a Name and stuff. And, like, they're the best. Like, I've never found anyone as good as them. And they're so busy, so I can't afford them. You know what I mean?
They're getting big now, aren't
they? They're getting big on TV, and their set was awesome. Like, I'm so happy for them. So, yeah, a band is fun in the right context. But, like, in that room, it would have been too noisy and kind of sloppy, you know? I just love the basics, the hip elements.
Yeah. When you originally started, back in, what was it, 2004,
03? Yeah, 03, I studied in Oxford as an undergraduate, and then in 03, an indie album came out, but 04 is when I started touring more over here. The laptop EP came out, so that was kind of like the genesis.
Yeah, you dubbed a certain age range. What did you dub it?
Oh, the I Generation.
Yeah, do you still stand by that?
Yeah, man, I think it's the kids, like, looking at the faces of all the kids, like, seeing them rapping 19th century literature and jumping around, like, it's cool to be nerdy. It's cool to, like, value education and want to study hip-hop. It's just, like, I was so inspired by the crowd. That's the I Generation, the kids who were born with the technology, who have the capability to change the world and help the human race evolve. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's awesome.
Would you consider yourself nerdy?
Definitely. I've come to terms with it, you know, in the past few years. I'm definitely a nerd, but I think being a nerd is cool because it means, you know, doing podcasts, you know, like doing video stuff, music. Anyone who's, Obama's a nerd, you know what I mean? Anyone who's like good at something has to be a little nerdy. So.
When you first started off with just you and the laptop, originally that was an amazing, you know, brand new concept to the world. Now as time's moved on, you know, more people have kind of adapted to that. How do you stay ahead of the rest of the game?
Dude, that's a great question. Like, I feel like 303 and a lot of like the hip hop, like, crossover stuff, it takes a similar thing, like the samples and the live drumming and the hip-hop. I think I just got to keep doing my own thing and, like, pushing the boundaries. My new album, Lars Attacks, has a lot of, like, screaming and, like, dubstep and, like, collabs with a bunch of different rappers. Like, I try not to do the pop-punk crossover stuff as much. I think I stay ahead of the curve by putting stuff that I love out and just trying to fuse genres and just being in charge and not needing some A&R guy, somebody talking in my ear about what elements I need. Because I know what I need to do artistically, and I'm going to keep doing it till I die. I'm going to take it to the grave, you know? Yeah. So it's pretty dope.
What is wrong and what is right with music these days?
That's a great question, man. I mean, I think what's wrong with music is that sometimes, because it's easy to create, there's a notion that, oh, well, if I put on a video on YouTube, I'll be famous in a day, and it will be easy. And I think having the tools, that's also what's right with it, you know what I mean? The accessibility of the technology is what's wrong with it, because it's like anyone can make music, but you need to realize it takes years and dedication, and you need to translate that into an exciting live show. If you do computer music, it's kind of boring unless you can make it happen in a live context. That's what I've learned. So, you know, it's cool that there's so much music now and the tools are there. I just think our culture is so fast and cut and paste, you know, people don't understand like the history of hip hop or the history of certain genres. And I think you really need to educate yourself and then build on the past.
Okay, well, how are you finding this festival so far? How do you find the North in particular?
The North has always been good to me, you know, like the North, there's just so much excitement, so much wonderful music culture up here. You know, the North is my favorite part of England. It's beautiful too, you know?
You're just saying that, are you?
No, I love the space. I mean, I like it. It's less crowded than the South, you know what I mean? Like, the food is better. It's wonderful. It's beautiful. And I love Scotland too. We played Aberdeen, which is in England, I know, but like, north is beautiful. I was like awestruck at the buildings in Aberdeen. So I'll keep coming back, you know? I plan to tour the UK every year until I'm an old, old man. As long as people care, I'll keep putting out albums. And doing it in the clubs, you know what I mean?
How did you find Slam Dunk Festival?
Probably one of the dopest festivals I've played, you know? Just the array of bands, the attitude, like how they turn this university into a bunch of venues, it's cool. The ska, the hip-hop, it's awesome. Like, I hope they ask me back because I had a really fun time. The crowd was awesome. They knew all the words, and like, I jumped into them, and they caught me, and it was really fun, man.
You have a lot of fans, don't you? And they all just love you, and they just can't stop. Obviously, it took us like a good half an hour just to get to you.
So, I know. Yeah, thanks. Like, sorry about that. I think it's just because I'm really in on the social networking with everyone. I run everything, so I'm always. You got to do that. You got to write everyone back. And I think being a single artist instead of a band makes that easier. You know what I mean? Because I have to maintain everything and keep in touch with everything. Because I feel like I have a friendship with every single person that loves my music. Because it's cool. It still blows my mind that I was able to make music in my dorm room in college, and now it's a career and people care. Like, that's crazy. That's still, like, I feel like I'm living a dream. You know what I'm saying? It's dope.